Hello and welcome to another widget builder tutorial. Here I will show you how to use the widgets you made inside the widget builder inside this drag dropper editor. Okay, now here you see our basic widgets and here you see our custom widgets that we made inside the widget builder. These are separated because these are public widgets, everybody can see them. And these are user widgets that we made and only we can see them. Okay, and if you watched the previous tutorials about widget builder, you remember we made the navigation menu and a burger menu. Okay, now let's see how they work. First, just drag the widget onto the screen. And here you see our widget settings. So these are a little bit different than of those other widgets because these are all the settings that we've made inside the widget builder. So these are all attributes, if you remember. So we had an icon attribute that we can choose our hamburger icon. We can choose whichever we want. Here we have font size. So these are all the attributes that we've made earlier. And you can customize them however you like. So the widget is as customizable as you make it. Okay. Now, if you remember this hamburger widget, we created it so that when we click this icon, we get to see our drop-down menu. And to see our drop-down menu, first we have to add items. So we are adding links to our hamburger menu. Okay, so let's add a home link and about. Let's say contact. Okay, that's enough for now. But what you can see is that when we click our icon, the menu doesn't show up. That is because we are inside the editor and all the drag dropper widgets have their own functionality. So we would like to be able to drag this widget and drop it. So when we click it, we don't want any our custom JavaScript to interfere with this basic functionality. So if we want to see our drop-down menu, what we have to do is first save the page and then click this when this icon turns white. So this is live preview. We want to preview the page. And here our drop-down menu works. So any custom JavaScript that you add to your widget won't work here inside the editor. It is turned off. So if you want to test your JavaScript functionality for your widget, you first save the page and then click live preview.